Come on. Come on. Give God big, big praise. Yeah, 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 yeah. Now, y'all, may God bless the prophet. Y'all get this. There are a lot of Christians who have some issues in their home and don't know that there are some particular issues coming against you in your house because of cursed objects in the house. And you don't even know the object is cursed. It's real. I don't care how saved you are. I don't care how many years you've been in church. I don't care if you're a pastor, a bishop, or whatever you are, an evangelist. You apostle, chief apostle. You can have some cursed objects in your home. And not even know it. Bishop. I know. I've been in homes of preachers and had to take stuff out of their house because there was some stuff going on. And guess what else? Some stuff can go on in your home. After a while, you realize that it's spiritual. You don't know where it's coming from at first. What's going on? Why is this happening? Why is this going on with me? Why am I this? Why am I depressed? Why am I panicked? Why am I fearful? Why am I so emotional? Why am I angry and nobody's done anything to me? Bless you. Why my money jacked? Why my relationships jacked? Everything. There's a cursed objects can mess you up. So, y'all.
What do we do though?
That's why I'm teaching. That's why I'm teaching. Because that's an excellent question, Brother Gerald. What do we do? I didn't know what to do. No one taught me. The stuff that I do, I didn't learn this. From the church, the Holy Spirit taught me. Because I had a willing heart to learn. So I went in that Bible and I began to get the supernatural spiritual things of God. So look, y'all. So with these cursed objects in people's houses, things are happening to them and they know not of what it's about. Now, I told you before, a woman stepped in here and then sat down crying in the back and then stepped out to go kill herself. She was going to go kill herself. She was messed up. Well, she had cursed objects in the house. And I went over there and got him out. She didn't want to kill herself no more. Her little boy was scared to sleep in the bed. In a bed other than him and his grandma anymore. You hear me? But I got to revisit this one. Because God told me to take you to the word and show it to you so you can really get this particular cursed object. If you're a member of a mega church, which they were, this family, the mega church, a member of Ebenezer in Fort Washington.
Yeah.
I love Ebenezer. But they're a member of Ebenezer. And their little baby is dying. The baby is dying. Little baby dying. Doctors can't do nothing with the child. The child is dying. But there was a reporter from CNN News that told them they need to come here. Oh. So the reporter from CNN News, you heard me, CNN News, the retired reporter called me and asked me if I would go over to their house for them. They want me to come to their house. I said, yeah, we'll go. Ms. Law and I went over to the house, big, beautiful house near here, built from scratch. But the baby's in the house dying. You better hear me. This is a true story. Ms. Long's with me. We go in the house and we meet the family for the first time. And when I get in your house to do a spiritual sweep of your house, I don't run in and get busy. No, I run in and start discerning the spirits up in there. I come in and, you know, I'm talking to you and I'm just looking around. And the Lord talked to me. Lord, show me what's going on around this home. Y'all hear me? Yeah, thank you, Ms. Lawn. He told me to remind you of how people get this wrong. A gift of discernment. No such gift. People saying all their lies. I got the gift of discernment. No, you don't. The Bible says it is the gift of discerning of spirits. Not the gift of discernment. Discerning spirits. You better be able to know when a demon is in your presence. You better know when a demon has invaded and trespassed and transgressed against your home. Better realize when a demon's on your job, whatever. It's called discernment of spirits. I don't care if you got a man hollering at you, telling you how beautiful you are. Girl, you single? Girl, you look good. You the best little thing I've seen in my life.
Keep it moving.
And guess what? And you might fall for it, but if you got the gift of discerning of spirits, someone this time you go, ding, 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 warning, warning. He's a hoe. Warning. He running through women like crazy.
Yes, Lord.
Got 10 babies by 10 different women. Tell how good he look. How good he smell.
Right.
You discern the spirit on him.
Yeah. Right? Tell the truth, Pastor.
So we're in the house. And I kind of stepped to the right. A big house, too. Y'all. I'm like, go ahead, Zion. Go ahead, baby. So look, I step to the side. I look down to the room. And I see the baby that's supposed to be dead soon. The baby is in a little thing. What do y'all call it?
Bassinet.
All right, baby. In a bassinet, right? And the baby's on the floor. On the floor. In a bassinet on the floor in front of the fireplace. You know how the fireplace got that brick stand and you put pictures on whatever you put on it? Well, there's something on the fireplace. I see the baby. I ain't run to that child. I could have. But God put supernatural wisdom in me. There's something there with the child. And I'm looking. Oh, boy. And I said, okay, God, what do I do? Because there's something with the child. Open up your Bibles now to the book of Judges. I'm sorry, no. 1 Samuel. Open up to 1 Samuel. 5th chapter, 1 Samuel. Open 1 Samuel, which comes before 1 and 2 Kings and Chronicles and all that. Go to 1 Samuel 5th chapter. I'm going to show y'all something. Y'all, they ain't never teach me this in no church. I don't know nothing about this. Amen. All my life since I was knee-high to a bunny rabbit. I ain't heard this in my life. It is in the Bible. Go to the 5th chapter. If you don't have a Bible, raise your hand right now. Because you got to see this with your own eyes. And we'll put a Bible in your hand. 1 Samuel 5th chapter. Go there for me. Cursed objects are real. 1 Samuel 5th chapter, y'all. So, I'm looking at that child. Oh, and I'm getting vexed in my spirit. I'm looking at the baby. I'm like, uh-oh. And I ain't going near that baby right now. No, no. God will release me. And I wait. But I see the baby. I'm going to show you something. Now. 1 Samuel, 5th chapter. Praise, get that Bible, man. Come on, get the Bible. Get the Bible, Mama.
Yeah, I gave it to him, but he said.
Come on, get the Bible, man. And turn to 1 Samuel. Come on, praise. Turn to it, man. Learn. Learn. Come on, man. Learn. You're in church. Learn. Oh, your name ain't praise for nothing. Learn, man. I know how young people are. Learn. 5th chapter of 1 Samuel. So look, so the baby's down there. Michelle, I see the baby, Sister Michelle. I see the baby. Quentin, I see the baby. And I pull my head like this. I step back out of the way, right? After I saw the baby, I stepped back out of the way. And sure enough, there were two objects. Miss Mom, do I have a baby? Oh, I got one. Yeah, okay. Yeah, I got a baby. Okay, I got a baby. Okay, I got a baby. Now, Now, let me show you how the baby was. Y'all pay attention because this is real. The baby is laying down like that. Bring this over here a little bit. Bring this here. The baby is laying down just like that. And I'm way down the aisle looking at the child. But the baby's laying down. Well, guess what? You go to a church, you're a member of a mega church. That's your child. And the doctor told you your baby will be dead in a few days. Not a few weeks, not a few months. Your baby will be dead in a few days. And nothing we can do with your child. Take your child home to die. So guess what? While the child is laying here, this right here was here, and one here is two of them. The child's laying under them. You got something to tell you. They were just objects. They weren't nothing. They're some objects. God told me that those objects took ownership of the baby. They took ownership of the baby. They deceived their parents. And the baby belonged to them now. And the baby is going to die. And they're there to make sure the baby does die. It was two of them. And I'm going to take you to the Word of God. And I'm going to show y'all something. These two covered the child. Don't worry, y'all. We broke the curse off these things now. So you ain't got to worry about it. They ain't got no power. Oh, but they had some power when I came across them. Baby laying in front of them. The baby laying down and they over the child like that. Y'all hear me? They over the child like that. And I'm looking at them. I ain't come nowhere near that baby yet. But I can see them. And God told me his name. Who they were. So I knew who they were. Are you with me in the fifth chapter?
Yes.
Okay. Let's look at the Word of God. God helped me teach the spiritual things and help Christians not to be spiritually ignorant like Paul said. I would not have you ignorant of Satan's devices. Is that your brother coming in here? I'm glad to see Pastor Carl. Oh, God. He ready to see something he never seen in his life. So, y'all see this thing? And God is talking to me about how they are guarding, they own that child, that baby belonged to them. And I heard something in the spirit realm. You come anywhere near this child, we'll kill you. I heard him loud and clear. I haven't come to the child yet. But they're telling me, they're warning me, don't come. Okay. Fifth chapter of 1 Samuel. Go to verse number 2. Are you there? When the Philistines took the ark of God, they brought it into the house of Dagon and set it by Dagon. And when they of Ashdod arose early on the morrow, behold, Dagon was falling upon his face to the earth before the ark of the Lord. And they took Dagon and set him in his place again. Fourth verse. And when they arose early on the morrow morning, behold, Dagon was falling upon his face to the ground before the ark of the Lord, and the head of Dagon and both the palms of his hands were cut off upon the threshold. Only the stump of Dagon was left to him. Five, therefore, neither the priests of Dagon, nor any that come into Dagon's house tread on the threshold of Dagon in Ashdod until this day. But the hand of the Lord was heavy upon them of Ashdod, and he destroyed them and smote them with emrods, even Ashdod and the coast thereof. Last verse. And when the men of Ashdod saw that it was so, they said, the ark of the God of Israel shall not abide with us, for his hand is sore upon us and upon Dagon our God. That's Dagon right there, y'all. Dagon. Representing the Dagon. A God. A demon God. Who had the child. But hold on. Are you ready? Turn to the next book, Judges. Let me show you what they were trying to do to the baby. Turn to the 16th chapter of Judges. Go to the 16th chapter of Judges. Are you at the 16th chapter of Judges yet?
Yes, I am.
Okay. I'm sorry. Am I there? Yeah. 16th chapter of Judges. What am I talking about? The next one. This is after Joshua. Hold on. What's the 16th chapter of Judges? This is after Joshua. Go back. Right. Just flip back. That's all. Right, just flip back to the 16th chapter of Judges. Just flip back a little bit. That's all. From where you were in 1 Samuel. Judges 16. Okay, I have it. Okay, still trying to get it? Hold on. Judges 16. Now, you do see Judges 16, right?
Yeah.
Okay, here's what they were doing with people, with human beings. If you look at Judges 16:23, look at it. Then the lords of the Philistines gathered them together for to offer a great sacrifice unto Dagon their God. You see that? To offer a great sacrifice. And it said right there, to Dagon their what?
God.
And to rejoice, for they said, our God have delivered Samson, our enemy, into our hand. Dagon. Dagon. So guess what? Now that God told me who he was, and I see the baby, I get down on the floor, on my belly, like I'm in the military. On my belly, then I miss the Lord? And on my belly, I walk, I crawl all the way to the baby so I'll be underneath Dagon. I crawled all the way to the baby and I grabbed hold of the baby's thing like this. I'm underneath Dagon. And I begin to pull the baby out from their control, from them. And I pull the child, still on my belly, still crawling. And I crawl all the way back to the parents in the other room, with the child. And I gave them the child. Got something to tell y'all. The child didn't die. The child lived in Jesus' name. Yeah. Come on up in here. The baby is still alive today. The baby didn't die in a few days. The baby lived. In whose name?
Jesus.
The baby lived.
Thank you, Jesus.
In Jesus' name, the baby lived. Now, I'm going to tell you this right now. A lot of people hit me, Miss Long. Hit me. Hit me and quit me. So, in Christian homes, I've gone in. So everything you buy, you're looking at the pretty part of it. Gerald, you ask, what do you do? Here's one thing you do. You begin to look at, Sister Betty, you look at the merchandise you're buying.
Right.
You begin to look at it.
All right.
Because if they have planted something in the photograph, in the clothing, in the furniture, God will show it to you if you look. And Ms. Long, do you have that angel picture back there? Oh, we got a picture of an angel that was in a house. Angel, beautiful. But behind the angel was a demon. Purse.
On the bed.
Oh, yeah. Well, Ms. Long just mentioned it. Some of y'all don't realize because you never research. But don't you buy your kids nothing else with the peace sign on it.
Oh, yeah.
The peace sign is a curse. It ain't about peace. This is an upside down cross. Y'all hear me? Peace sign. It's an upside down cross. Y'all got me? Stay away from it. In Jesus' name. So look. So, gracious. Hold on. Now, I'm glad the preacher brought this stuff in here. Because a lot of stuff been going on. And she brought her stuff in here to see if it's cursed objects. Because a lot of times they can be like they praying, like they worshiping. And you look a little closer, it can be something on there. Got no business on there. But do you hear me? Huh? Yeah, well, I'm going to tell you something. On those other ones we found curses on last week, if they come with them, you get rid of everything. You get rid of all of them. Do you understand what I'm saying to you? Sometimes we found things, especially on religious things. It spins around. Okay, especially. Oh, God. Hold on. Look at that face. Look at inside. Look at her mouth. She's a demon. Look at that. Who sings like that? Tell me who sings like that. Good grief, man. I ain't putting this in my house. I'm not putting that in my house. I'm not putting that in my house, okay? I'm not putting that in my house, okay? Exactly. Look at her face. Look at her. Look at her face. Okay, look at her face. There's something wrong here. Take my word for it. And I see witch all over. And you don't know where these things are saying here. If you got something with a language on that you don't understand, why is it on your wall? Because you don't know what they're saying. They might be saying, we hate God. We love Satan. You don't know what they're saying. Yeah, the Last Supper. Everybody loved the Last Supper, right? But guess what? In the Last Supper, we got a Last Supper picture. And you got Jesus with the disciples. But you didn't see what was behind Jesus and the disciples. And when you look into it, they got demonic faces all in the shadow, all in the back. Yeah. Why? Because Satan worshipers know that Christians are going to buy Christian stuff. But they're not going to really look at it because you're looking at the picture, but you're not looking at what else is around the picture. I told you, Evangelist Rachel Trehance, who was singing on the first one, on the old radio revival, that was her singing, and Miss Long was on there, and she was doing the worship music. She got a job at a thrift shop. And she already knew I was teaching. And she tried to buy the cursed objects that people were buying off so people wouldn't buy it. She said, Pastor, people are coming here buying cursed objects and taking them out. And she could see the curses all on, but they couldn't see them. So she tried to buy them so she could destroy them. But she couldn't buy all of them. Y'all hear me? You think Satan worshipers or antichrist spirits are stupid? They know how to plant things. That's why the Bible said everything that was planted, that was not planted by the Heavenly Father shall be what? Oh, here it is. Uh-oh, here it is. Whoa, look at him. What's this got to do with a daggone? Hold up. I'm going to see if anyone here can point him out. Here's a beautiful angel. Now you point out what ain't supposed to be in there. You show me what ain't supposed to be in this picture with this beautiful angel. See the angel, Christians? Christian, you tell me what ain't supposed to be in this picture. Oh, y'all ain't seen yet as big as it is? As big and bold as that demon is, y'all ain't seen him yet. Brandon, you see him, don't you? Charlene, you see him, some Charlene? You see him? Come on. Come on, you see him yet? What has he got to do with this angel? You see him yet? If you ain't seen him yet, come on. You ain't seen him yet? Thank you, Karen. You got him. Thank you. There he is. Thank you. There he is. Thank you. See him? What do you got to do with this picture? Nothing. Let me show you. Hold on. I'm going to turn it around. I'm going to turn it around. See if you see him. Come on. Show him to me. Hold on. How old are you? Huh? You seven. And you pointing them out. You 7 years old. And she pointed right to him. See him? See him? Since Pata, do you see him yet? You see him, y'all? See him? What? I know from church. What is he doing here? What is he doing here? What is that face? Do you see that face? A face of a full dog. A wolf, teeth out, black eyes, and demon ears.
The whole thing looked like a dog.
The whole picture. And we got this off the wall. Look at that. Even there. Hold on. Y'all. And the house was being cursed big time. All they saw was the angel. You see him? How old are you? 10. And he said, oh, look at that. He pointed right at him. Well, you got Christian in church, got it on their wall, cursing their family and them. Look at that. It's real, y'all. This is real. This is very real. It's very real. I see this in homes every time we go in there to do business to get them out. Oh, I was just talking about this. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Hey, y'all, by show of hands, and you show me your hand, you in church. Because we had some preachers to raise up their hands when I did this before. How many of y'all have ever played with a Ouija board? Hold your hands up. I want to see. Yeah. Who else? Yeah. Okay, thank y'all. Now. Where is it? Okay, let me have the Ouija board. Oh. Bam, the Ouija board. Now. I got something to tell y'all about the Ouija board. Many of your old schoolers grew up playing Monopoly. Santa Claus used to bring Monopoly. It was the number one board game in America for many years. Many, 40, 50 years. Whoever. Monopoly was number one. Before Toys R Us closed down, this became the number one game in America. Santa Claus was bringing this more than Monopoly. Why? Because of New Age, because of the occult, fooling the people, telling the people it's a nice game. But hold on. It's a nice game. This was hiding in your house, remember? They couldn't find it. When you went in there and told them, because he learned from here. And when he went in their house, thing was hiding, but he finally found it. I remember when the Minister Fingers had one. But guess what? Are you ready for this? Someone just told me, I just heard this from Rick Renner, internationally known preacher on attached with Kenny Copeland there. His name is Rich Renner, R-E-N-N-E-R. He said that yesterday, he said they had a Ouija board. Whoa. Playing with it in their house. He said one day he and his sister grabbed the Ouija board and they put it on the ground. Started asking the questions. He said the Ouija board started moving on his own and started answering their questions. And they knew then, uh-oh, something's wrong here. But there are people who've been in here told us the same thing. It started moving across the board by itself. Have you ever bought your kid one of these?
No.
A lot of people have. I'm down in South Carolina. A gospel singer going to sing his new song. I'm in his room, sitting on his bed. He's singing his song. My foot keep hitting, my heel of my foot kept hitting something. I'm sitting there, kept hitting something. I'm down there in Santee, South Carolina. And I'm hitting something. So I didn't finish singing. I said, excuse me, but my heel keep hitting something. What is this? And he pulled out a Ouija board. The gospel singer. Wouldn't I have you ignorant of Satan's devices? So I immediately explained to him he had to get this out of his house. That it was totally demonic and they will talk to you. Y'all hear me? So a lot of people got that in their home. Let me have that pillow. And the way we break these curses, oh God, I'm gonna tell you something right now. When you find something demonic in your house, just don't throw it out. Declare over that the curse is broken in Jesus' name. If you move to anoint that thing with oil, we even know a lot of pieces of oil have killed it, crushed it, and got it out in Jesus' name. A lot of times, tell you what we have learned. You ready? When we've gone into apartment buildings to get the cursed objects out, a lot of them have those great big green trash things out. What are they called? Yeah, dumpsters out there, right? Well, here's what we learned. You take a cursed object out to the dumpster and you throw it into the dumpster. Ready for this? Here comes somebody, innocent. And all of a sudden something is pulling on them. Seriously, it's happened. It's pulling on them. They don't know, but they feel it. Curiosity. They go over to see what it is. They say, oh, that's Perry. Who threw this away? This is Perry. Let me take this home. Bam. So, Miss Long, tell them what we start doing now. Taking a hammer, putting it inside the green bag, boom, boom, destroying it before we put it in the dumpster so it can't call nobody. Are y'all hearing me? Say it, First Lady. I wish Juliet was here. Because I thought she was going to bring that demonic picture today. Yeah, that we tore that thing up and smashed it. Yeah, we smashed it. In Jesus' name. Knowing that we're all to smash it. Hold on, Miss Lauren. Yeah. Oh, that way, right? Bam. Yeah, a lot of people got this. A whole lot of people got this. Look, y'all. Teeth and eyes. You're right. Oh, well, keep looking. I see it. I see it big time. I see it. Keep looking. I know you can see it. Totally demonic. Thank God she bought it here. Got it out of her house. Why? Because she learned it here. So she started looking for things. It's demonic. Face of a demon on it. A Miss Lola, where the panties at? Come on, give me the panties. Okay, give me the panties. Got something to tell y'all. A little bitty girl, this ain't for y'all women. Mama bought this for her little 12-year-old daughter wearing these pants. And mama came up in here.
Because
See him? See him? See him, Sister Pamela? Sister Pamela, this church is different. See it? Yeah, now you know. See him? See him? Yeah, kitty panties. See him? She came up in here to visit. No, she didn't, because she didn't know no better. She came up here to visit and got taught. She went home and got her daughter panties and bought them here. Because, got something to tell y'all, y'all ready? The little girl, 12 years old, was having female problems in her womanhood, in her vagina. She was having issues that she shouldn't have had at her age. Why? Because she had a spirit of death on her vagina. And mama didn't know it. Mama bought them for her. Christians buying cursed objects and bringing them home. This is a curse. This, if you go to the hospital with the bones under, they got this on toxic stuff that can kill you. What you think is on that poison that kill you, cyanide, this. And you putting this crap on your babies. Christians better wake up. Christians, you better wake up. Christians, these are cursed objects. Y'all hear me? Hold on. And why the first lady wearing these? And why was the first lady wearing these? Why she wearing spirit of death on her feet and sitting up in church in the pulpit? What's going on with the church? The pastor's wife wearing these? The pastor's wife wearing these? Are you kidding me? Haven't been taught. How shall they know except they preach? Oh, you better get a closer look then. Pass that down. No, it can't hurt you now. Look at it. Scars all over it. Scars all over it. Anybody else need to see it closer? Come on, you want to see it closer? I'll give it to you. Scars all over like the panties. Yeah, they should be. Pray. Next time I move, turn it. Turn it. You got me? It's real. It's real. See him? It's real. It's real. It's real. Scars all over the first lady. Hold on. The first lady. What happened to the first lady, Pastor? Who's wearing these demonic death shoes? What happened to her? Well, she left her husband. Well, why did she leave her husband? She left her husband to run away with a woman. True story. She's walking in here. She ran. She left her husband for a woman. Chris, obviously don't play. They don't play. Hey, y'all hear me? They don't play. Dad,
they don't play fair.
I mean, what do you mean? I got it. They don't play. They are real. They are real. Hold on. Miss Long, come here. Oh, that's right. Come here. Y'all can't tell me what's wrong with this picture. Not one person in here. Oh, except y'all I showed it to before.
Right.
Don't say a word. Right. Tell me what's wrong with the Last Supper. Because you already know you was here. You already know, don't say a word. Tell me what's wrong with the Last Supper. Pray. Turn. Come on, man. Tell me what's wrong with the Last Supper, y'all. Come on, Sister Pam. Come on. You was here, weren't you? Or you weren't, but you saw it, didn't you? Sister Charlene got it. Oh, you see it. Thank you. He saw it. Who else can see it? Huh? Hold on, I'm coming over there. What's wrong with this? Keep looking. What's wrong with it? There's something real wrong with it, dadgummit. Look at it. What's wrong with it?
A lot.
A lot is wrong with it. It's making a statement that it shouldn't be making. Huh?
That's not good.
You got to get rid of it. It got to be destroyed. Once you oil it up. Oh, but you can't keep it. You can't keep it. Once you take that cursed object from your house, and you put oil on it, you cannot then break it and keep it. You can't see it. I'm going to show it to y'all then. If she couldn't see it, I'm going to show it to y'all. Ready? Here it is. How many disciples is it? Then where the woman come from? Where does the woman come from, y'all? Where does she come from? Tell me where she come from. One, two, three. Oh, there's two women. Two women. They ain't got no business at the last supper. No, does the Bible say anything big? Dadgummit, two women here. Two, not one, but two. Two women. Two women. Two women at the Last Supper.
Yeah.
They said in the Bible who was there. Huh? I don't know. Ain't no woman, especially two, sitting at the Last Supper. Y'all hear me, y'all? Read your Bible. No, it's not. He was making a statement that he shouldn't have been making. That's a lie. That's a lie from the pit of hell. Are y'all hear me? Any more from here? Now, you break the curse by speaking to it, you anoint it, and you get it out. Now, I remember having a cursed object in my house for 10 years and didn't even know it. 10 years. And one day I'm sitting in the room and God showed it to me. It was a photo. I mean, it was a painting. And when I saw it, I couldn't shake it. It was there. I kept looking at it. Damn, come on, yeah. I love the painting. You painted all beautiful in the family room. But I saw that thing and I couldn't take my eye off of it. I couldn't ignore it anymore. Till I finally took them off the wall and brought them in here. And it's real. Okay. Now, y'all, in the, oh God. Demonic. Totally demonic. Come on, little genie boy. Come on, y'all. You don't put this on your table. Come on, y'all. Yeah, sorcerer. That's a sorcerer. That's a magic man. Y'all hear me? In the name of Jesus, we're breaking all the curse off this stuff now. Breaking everything off them. And we're going to break them up. We're going to break them up. Oh, one time I broke up a cursed object in a preacher's house and the sucker cut me. I was bleeding. Yeah, sucker. Sure did. Cut me. And I kept right on doing what I was doing. It didn't stop me. Sure did cut me. And it was a preacher. I'll tell you who preacher it was. Oh, what's the senator's name? What's the senator's name right here? Moose, one of his associate ministers' house, called me. She called me to come over there to get the curse out of her house, and she was Senator Anthony Moose, associate minister. I went over there and got him out. But that thing cut me. It cut my hand in her dining room. I never forget it. Sure did cut me. Oh, hold on. That prophet just didn't want to give up that picture. I don't make anyone get rid of the object when we point it out to them in their house. I show it to you. I tell you what it is. It's your choice. Well, man, well, guess what? I'm at a prophetess house and begin some cursed objects out. But she had something in there, and I told her it was cussing the whole house. She did not want to get rid of that. Ooh, she was standing. She did not want that thing to go. So about a half an hour, I won't want to argue with her. It's cursed. What was it? If you got in your house, go get it off. It's the picture where a lot of people have. The curse is not Dr. Martin Luther King on there. The curse is not somebody else that's on there. The curse is, what's his name, Ms. Lauren? Malcolm X on there. If you got a picture of Malcolm X on your wall, you are agreeing with the spirit of an antichrist and a false god, false religion. And so many got that picture on their wall, Christians. I saw a church with it on their wall, and it's still on there. There's a church in D.C. with it on their wall, and it's still there now. Great people, they got, hold on, they don't only have Malcolm X on there, but they got his leader on there. What's his leader name? Elijah Muhammad on there. In the church, in the pulpit. I don't call his name out. Y'all know him.
I know who it is.
No, give it to him. No, give it to him. Let's get the mic. Let's give it to him. Y'all hear me with these things? Check your house. Oh, but another thing. Say that your house don't feel right now. It's just something, you know.
Something's not right.
Something's not right. Maybe it's a little tense in there. People not getting along right now in the house. Your feelings are a little off right now. Some things are off. You know why? You've been transgressed against. Some way, somehow, an unclean spirit is trespassing against your home, and he's laying low, but he's in there messing with you and your family. You don't even know he's in there. Whenever, I don't care whose house you have, how holy, I don't care how many Bibles you got in your house. When there is a trespasser, and you realize that the atmosphere is not right, stop being natural with it. Get spiritual with that thing. Say, And if you do, there'll be a shift in the atmosphere. How do you do it? I'm sure how you do it real quick. Let me tell you about this preacher. He did a revival for a whole month and left his wife and kid home. Little boy like him. Came back home, met him at the airport. He went home. He said, the first couple days he's back home, he noticed something ain't right in my house. He been gone a whole month. Something ain't right with my wife nor my child. He knew then. So he did a spiritual sweep. Everything came back to normal. My house, my own house, when everything is chaotic, everybody's chaotic, guess what? I've got my whole family. And they took that Bible. Better hear me in your house. Y'all can do it anyway. If you've never been done in your house, you better do it. And only do it in the daytime. Don't ever do it at night. You hear me? You turn it to Matthew 10:1. Everybody who live with you, walk with you to every room in your house. Every space in your house, they walk with you. When you get to the door of the area, read Matthew 10:1 out loud into that area. Yeah. And when he had called unto him, his 12 disciples gave him power against unclean spirits to cast them out. And to heal all manner of sickness, all manner of disease. Hold on. Once you speak it in the area, take Matthew 10:1, throw it up in the room. Let me hear you say, excuse me. There is no power in the natural. Y'all, we talking spiritual things here. The natural realm is subject to the spirit realm. God is a spirit. And they that worship him must worship him in what? In spirit and in truth. The devil don't want you to get spiritual on him, because that's the only way you're going to get him out. That's the only way you're going to break his weapons. The only way you're going to root him out. Your house in an uproar. So look. So you throw that Matthew 10:1 in that area. And then y'all walk into the room. I always plead the blood over the room. And this is what I say. In the name of Jesus, I command every unclean spirit to go from here now and never return. Y'all hear me? After you say that, here's what you got to say now. I now declare this area holy ground. Holy ground. Come on, y'all. Ain't no demon gonna stay on the holy ground. I now declare it holy ground. And nothing evil can dwell here. And I may anoint the entrance to the room. And sometime I may anoint the window. But I, definitely you got to anoint the entrance. Okay? Then you go to the next area. Each one of them read out loud into the area. So that's all you're going to do. You're going to read Matthew 10:1 out loud. Oh, here's something very important. Save the master bedroom for last. Go in any room you want to in your whole house, but save that master bedroom for last. Because that's where the people who are in charge of the household sleep. The strong man coming in there, because if he can come into your dreams, he can bring you some nightmares. If he can bring you some distress and oppression and fear and all this stuff, if he can mess with you in there, then it's going to mess up your whole household. Because the leader's going to go down to the... You hear me? Say your master bedroom for last. But you do that. Again, read Matthew 10:1 out loud in the area. Throw Matthew up. And then plead the blood of Jesus in the area. Declare holy ground. Anoint it and go. Once you get you in the master bedroom, you got everybody with you. Every time we do it, favor will read in one area. Praise will read in the area. First lady to read in the area. Angela, I believe, will read in the area. And I'm doing the work. You got it? But they'll read out loud in the area. Now, open your closets and do the same thing into them closets. Yeah. Closets got some stuff in them. Yeah. Bathroom, everything. Yeah. Check it out for me. You throw it in. Yeah.
The hotel room.
Guess what, Evangeline D? You're going to save a lot of people from some jacked up stuff. Thank you. Y'all go into hotels and go in and put the suitcase down and have a good time and lay down, watch the TV and go in and out. You go into a hotel room, you don't know who slept in that bed before you got there. You don't know who was up in that room. Excuse me. Suppose a witch slept in the same bed that you were sleeping in, or a warlock. Suppose a pedophile was sleeping in there. How about this? A rapist. An atheist. Y'all hear me? A divinator. How about this? A murderer. Y'all hear me? How about some men sleeping with men was in that bed, or some women sleeping with women, and now you laying up in there? Y'all, stop taking stuff for granted. If you get spiritual, your life will be better all the way around. You'll be stronger. You'll have a sound mind. You'll be richer. You'll be happier. You'll have more joy. You'll have more peace. You'll have more Jesus. You'll have more power. And you will have more freedom than you ever had before. Oh, he said, why you don't ever do it at night? That's a good question. I don't ever do it at night because God just told me. He told me don't do it at night. I didn't ask him why. I've never done it at night, never will. I've been doing it for 20-some years. I've gone in houses all over. And I've got them out of their home, and it's always in the daytime. Hear me? Say it.
No, I was wondering about
Masonic stuff? I get out your house. Secret society. And some of them have told me some of the pledges they've made are very antichrist. That's me. Why, that's me. Oh, that's me. That's me outside praying for people in 2020 when they were pulling up. We were praying for them because they couldn't come in. Wednesday, 12 to 3. Oh, wow. Drive-through prayers. Here you go, Zion. You can have it, baby. I got plenty. Now. Yeah. Oh, okay. Yeah, Mrs. Long was bold that day. out in the parking lot. Remember Johnny? I'm going to get to the books. But when you get to the master bedroom, you got me? Another thing I do too, when I'm getting cursed, I was out. I don't leave the room until I say to God, something's hiding. I say, God, don't let me leave this room with something left behind. I do that for every house of men. God, is there anything in this room? And sure enough, sometimes, Elder, hold there. Sometimes, sure enough, I'm getting ready to leave. I'm declaring the holy ground. I'm thinking I'm finished with this room, if that's right there, Pamela. I said, God, is there anything in it? Sure enough, there is something hiding. So I always ask him before I leave, anything hiding in here? God will show you. He wants it to be free. So when you get to the master bedroom, you do the same thing you did. You read Matthew 10:1 out, and you throw it up. But before you leave, you take Matthew 10:1 and lay it on everybody's body. Each one take the Bible and lay Matthew 10:1 on their bosom before you leave, because it's the last room that you're doing in your house. They lay it on the body. Be quiet, because the word's going to jump off the pages into your body from head to toe, and it's going to permeate every organ, every bone, heart, mind, everything, soul, spirit. Y'all hear me? Let me hear you say supernatural.
Supernatural.
This is supernatural stuff. Yeah, Brandon.
I was going to say about the hotel, but my mom, she take a step further now. Every time she go to a hotel, she say anybody died in that room?
That's right.
Yeah.
Right.
She asked him.
Yes.
If she asked, don't they have to tell her?
No.
Oh, they're not going to tell her?
No.
Okay, because hold up a minute. Hold up a minute. I'm glad you brought that up. I got something to tell y'all. Ready? Are ready?
You can sense
it, can't you? Anybody ever seen Shaw Middle School or Rhode Island Avenue? In D.C.? Well, they had a principal. You ready? True story, they had a principal. Principal bought a house in Silver Spring, he was. And he had his church people come over and bless the house. That's not enough. So they blessed the house and they left. But hold on. Strange things started happening in his house. You better hear this. Strange things. He called the real estate agent up. And guess what? By law, if he had asked this before he bought, he tried to get out the deal. Too late. You're in it now. He asked, had anything happened in his house? Anybody been killed in this house? Like we just said. Guess what? Three people had been murdered in that house. They were murdered in that house.
Yeah.
Hold up. Story didn't stop there. Are you ready? I said the principal of Shaw. Are you ready? A few months later, they murdered him in the same house. And his dog. And his daughter. Murdered him in the same house. They did murder his daughter. Murdered him in the same house. You tell me that's a coincidence. No such word. Tell me it's happened, Spence. No such word. No, it was playing. It was unclean trespassing spirit dealing with them. And you going to get killed too? Come on, y'all. Oh, yeah. Suppose you come into a hotel room or you move into a house where they were in there working their stuff. Working some witchcraft, and you gonna come in the hotel room and not do nothing? No, man, we come in, we clean it. We come in. Now, if you see something demonic in that hotel room, and sometimes you do, you can't do nothing about it. Me and Ms. Long was in a hotel in New York City. Oh, by the way, and I told you, we don't charge a dime. People flying us all over the country. We drove up to New York, to Queens, New York, to get these demons out of the house twice. Two different families. And me and Ms. Lawn in the hotel, he in one room and I'm in another room. But guess what? He and me saw something. You talking about some cursed objects. The blankets were cursed. And the carpet was cursed. 666s was all over the place. So guess what we did? What we did was we knew we couldn't throw that stuff out. But we anointed the stuff and we took the blanket off the beds. And we declared what we do. We threw Matthew 10:1 in there. And we was able to do what we do. To go into those houses, get those demons out of the houses. And that family was rich. With cursed objects in the house. That family traveled the world bringing cursed objects back from every nation. They didn't even know it. That family was smart and working on Wall Street. Making big bucks. And me and Ms. Lawton, they have a beautiful home in Queens. Oh, please, Ms. Lawton, I hate that one. They had aluminum foil. See, when you haven't been taught, you try stuff. And inside the aluminum foil, balls of aluminum foil, the different parts of the house, tell them what was in it.
Split pea and like coins.
And garlic.
Yeah, garlic. That was supposed to keep the demons up. Right. That
was bringing, garlic. Was bringing more in. Hold on, it wasn't finished. Some prophet gave them an envelope. Anybody give you an envelope? You better open it and I'm going to see what's in here. But how about this? You got an envelope from a prophet. And the envelope ain't been opened in 5 years.
You got it in your wallet. You got it in his wallet, the one over the front door.
And you walk in the door, you got to walk under that envelope. Mm-hmm. And you walk out of the door, you walk under that envelope. Well, guess what, dog? I'm bold. I mean, I'm like, oh, what's in the envelope? Well, the prophet gave it to us and said it would protect us. And now I said, well, I tell you what, you mind if I open the envelope? How long has it been there? 5 years? You never opened it. I said, well, guess what? I'm opening it. I took that envelope down. I opened that envelope up. And inside the envelope was written out curses. Written out declaring demons over them. And he told him he was a prophet. Declaring all kinds of stuff over them. Had the pentagram drawn in there, the Satan's pentagram drawn in there and everything. True story. Me and him was there.
He was walking around with that in his back pocket.
In his back pocket for years. And hold on. While he's walking around with it, he getting sick. Passing out.
And now that same man is under attack with his memory.
Yeah. With that mention messing with him. Y'all hear me? They're Christians. So, y'all, you clean your house this week. You clean your house this week. Don't wait. Say it. Same thing. Curse. Superstition. Get all four-leaf clothes out your house. Huh?
Superstition.
What? Yeah. College dorm. When we took, when we dropped Trinity off at the University of Maryland, we just didn't let her go into that college dorm room. You know how many demons are in those dorms? Those kids doing everything. Now, we did a cleansing of that dorm room, y'all.
Praise the Lord.
So listen. Now, you go in your home, you take that Matthew 10:1, and you do a cleansing. It can bring sick, man, those demons can bring sickness and disease in your house. All types of stuff. But if there are some witches working against you, if they're working against you, they're sending stuff, you got to do something. Oh, hold up. Y'all knew how many witches were working against me. Y'all have no, oh God. Y'all. Ms. Lawn, I wish we had that little demon they left at my doorstep in my own home. Yeah, the one with the hair. Yeah, I wish you could find it. They ain't scared me. Yeah.
Oh, make sure they take it down because came through the
room
with a lot of smoke.
Oh, okay, yeah. Just check out everything. Because people come in there and leave cigarettes, smoke, and all kinds of smoke. They're doing stuff. So clean your room this week. I'm putting that on y'all right now. Clean it this week. It only takes a few minutes. Ain't nothing hard. Somebody may not walk with you, and you can't make them walk with you. Yeah, they could be. A Miss Long. Me and Miss Long went in a house in Seals Green to do a sweep. I've never seen nothing like this in my life. Me and Miss Long go in the house, and the mice are running all over the house.
Oh, yeah, I've seen something.
Well, hold on. We in the house, and a mouse gets on the baseboard and start charging towards us. I'm looking at this mouse coming like this. Hold up, you ready? She has a couch in her living room that she takes naps on. I flipped that daggone couch over there, Miss Long. I flipped it. Oh, y'all, I'm a bad motor scooter when it comes to stuff like this. When I'm on a mission from God, I'm going to take care of business. I'm going to get the thing out. Guess what? I flipped that couch out here. Guess what? A big hole in the middle of the couch and a whole nest of mouse run out. About 10 or 12 of them. Oh, I said, Miss Long, give me that broom. Miss Long, hand me that broom. I broke the woman's broom. I broke the woman's broom and everything. Then Miss Long broke the broom and everything.
She had put down salt all over her.
See there?
Yeah, she had done somebody her. Told her the salt was going to keep the demons out.
But going back to what you said, if someone's living there, I went to that because she had a son, a grown son. He wasn't home when we came. In his room, he had all kinds of stuff in his room. Didn't even know. He had so much cursed up in his room. He was opening doors to his mama's house. The mama was jacked up mentally, emotionally, and physically. And we love that woman. But the son was in his room with stuff.
She was on all these medications.
Jesus.
Oh,
wow.
Yeah.
One woman apartment. This is what you get when you bring curse out. She's a Christian.
Yep. Real sweet lady.
If you got someone in your house who won't walk with you, you do it, you go and do it. Because we've had some where they wouldn't go. I've even had them have kids stay out of school and go. Stay out of school to go. Especially when the little girl all of a sudden got a real issue. I'm sorry. She now want to talk about death all the time. From out of nowhere. She's also standing in the middle of the room in the classroom and peeing. And this girl's 12 years old. She also lost all her friends. She also came from the honor roll down to flunk and everything. Until I went up into the house. Found out that there was something there that was doing it. And after I got out of the house, she returned back to normal. On the road, friends and everything. Yeah. Y'all hear me? This is real. These people lives we talking about. I can't ignore these trials for help. All right, let me get ready to roll out of here. But
something Pastor mentioned earlier about having like the picture with Malcolm X and Dr. Martin Luther King together.
Yeah.
Well, the reason why that is cursed, okay, why you don't want that in there, you can't mix Christianity
with
any other religion.
Thank Amen? You.
So I'm going to give you this scripture, which is one that Pastor has given for years.
Right, get a scripture.
Amen.
Second, the word, back it up. Yeah,
Second John, just one page, okay, but it starts at verse number 6. And this is love. This is love. That we walk after his commandments. This is the commandment that ye have heard from the beginning, ye should walk in it. For many deceivers, do you hear that? Many deceivers are entered into the world.
Come on.
Who confess not that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh. This is a deceiver.
Say it.
And an antichrist.
Hold up, Miss Long. You're reading the scripture that God gave me 28 years ago.
It's got to be, let me see, 98, 30 years
ago. Yeah, 30 years ago he gave me that. And I started, these people started getting mad at me. Old cousin got mad at me. Why? Guess why? Mm-hmm. The Million Man March had hit. And I told my brother, I'm not going. Pastors, I was at this pastor's Baptist pastor conference in D.C. You should have seen all them getting buses together and bragging about going. I said, I'm not going. My cousin got mad. He said, we coming from North Carolina. I'm going to be on the bus. I'm coming up there. I said, I'm not going. And I told him why I couldn't go. So I'm in the School of Divinity on Howard University campus at the Watson Saturday College. And it's my senior year. I've been there 4 years. I got my degree from there. But guess what? I'm in there. And I told the professor and the whole class why I wasn't going and showed them that word. Guess what? After I did that, every one of them said, we're not going either. But the truth will make you free. Read it again, Miss Lord. Now, this is why I did not go to the Million Man March. And you have all them pastors going. Read it again.
That is it. Go ahead, first lady.
Oh, we had Jamal Bryan with Farrakhan on the same page.
I know. Farrakhan and...
Amen. For many deceivers are entered into the world who confess not that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh.
Thank you.
This is a deceiver.
Come on.
And an antichrist.
Come on.
Look to yourselves that we lose not those things which we have wrought, but that we receive a full reward. Whosoever transgresseth,
here it is,
and abideth not in the doctrine of Christ, had not God.
Come on.
He that abideth in the doctrine of Christ, he had both the Father and the Son. Last verse.
That last verse. Yeah. Listen to it now.
Well, actually, it's two more.
Don't verses. Be nice. I'm going to be nice because they gave me a pamphlet. Read it.
If there come any unto you and bring not this doctrine, the doctrine of Jesus Christ, the Son of God.
Come
amen.
On.
Amen.
What did it say?
Receive him not into your house. Neither bid him Godspeed.
Don't even tell him have a good day.
For he that biddeth him Godspeed is partaker of his evil deed.
Ooh, you tell him have a good day, you're now partaking in his evil deed.
Amen.
Ms. Alon and I sometimes we laugh at each other because you know people are used to saying, oh, okay, have a nice day, blah blah blah. And sometimes me and Ms. Alon know that that is someone, an antichrist spirit, that just waiting on us as we going out in the park and some of that. And out of our mouth, we want to say something, and we swallow it.
Yeah,
have a day. And we swallow it, don't we?
Yeah, we swallow.
We swallow. Even though they say something, we don't respond. Because God said, you tell them have a good day, you partaking in their evil deeds. Last one. Ain't no way. Last one. Gotta be kidding. Last one. No way. Yeah, ooh, it's right. No way. Y'all see this? You had this in your house. Some of your babies gonna be jacked. No way. Hold on, Miss Long, give me Fertitti, whatever her name is. Give me Nefertitti right there. Right there behind you. Yeah, her right there with a big round head. In front, Miss Long. In front of the brown thing. Over there. Yeah, right there, Miss Long. That's okay. Yeah. Whatever her name is. Whatever her name is, Nefertiti or Alpha Greedy or. Well, who is she then? Isn't it Nefertiti? Mom? I know it's a fertility. What? What's her name? Okay, that one. Okay, well, see this? This is, I've seen this in people's apartments as I was growing up as a teenager. It's supposed to be fertility so you can have a baby. But guess what God told me? God says the total opposite. God said, you got this in your house. She's sacrificing a baby to her God. See that right there? And then you think she got two little children around her at the bottom. They're not, they're two demons. See them? There are two demons at the bottom. And they're sacrificing. So if you see this in my house, you tell them, she's there to kill the sacrifice, to kill the kids, okay? All right. Now, before you go, let me pray over you. Oh, no, I got it. Now, right where you are, we're in a deliverance revival now. Before you walk out this door, the supernatural hand of God will touch you. All sickness and disease is going to leave your body. Oh. Brother Willie, come here for a minute, man. Y'all. Whoa, come here, bro, Willie. Well, I'm glad to see you, man. Come here. Come here, bro, Willie. Y'all, I hope I got this right, bro, Willie. Ooh, bro, Willie, come here, bro, Willie. Y'all. Ooh, bro, Willie, former trustee in this church. Bro, Willie, tell them how you attacked in your body. First, tell them what happened to you. Hold on for a minute. Stop right there. So you know your first time on the mic in here. Excuse me for a minute. Heaven's best. In this church, there is no what?
Judging.
Say it louder.
Judging.
No judging. Because any member in this church been through a lot of hell. And they joined here because they got delivered here.
Yeah.
Got healed here. And we know that. There are a lot of people out there who've been licensed, ordained in this church out there preaching now. When they came here, they were jacked. You got me? A Ms. Long had so many curses. It didn't make no sense. He got them all broken by coming here. Talk to me. Is it on Ms. Long?
Yeah.
Let me see. Hallelujah. Yeah. Okay, talk to me.
It was determined, doctor said I had cancer of the kidney.
Cancer of the kidneys?
Yes, cancer of the kidney. So June the 16th, this past year, they took my right kidney. In the process of taking my right kidney, they snagged my colon.
Stop right there. In surgery.
In surgery.
Hold on, stop right there. The former governor, female of Pennsylvania, went around and did a total research of hospitals. She said 80% of the patients in the hospital die in there for something that they didn't go in there for. 80% die of something they didn't go in the hospital for. Something happened. Now you can throw that word up to me, which ain't in the Bible, it's a demon. You can throw sepsis up all you want. Or they got sepsis. My brother did not die of cancer. Jesus healed him through me. He's supposed to have been dead in 8 days, he lived 8 more years. Know what killed my brother? Pneumonia in that hospital. He didn't have pneumonia when he went in.
She went in for seizure and died of pneumonia.
When we go to hospital, I teach you here, you go in the hospital. Mr. Clarence Ross was on the phone with me the other day. He said, Pastor, I remember you told us walk in the hospital like we own it.
Amen.
He said he did. You walk in Jesus' name like you own it. And you go in there and you go to work. Now you tell me that they cut your colon. Okay, keep going.
In the process of cutting my colon, I didn't know it. And about 8 days later, I lost all sense of responsibility as far as bathroom, weight, even I didn't know what's going on. I was talking to the walls. I was just doing
you were
just doing
that if they mess you up mentally and physically.
Yes.
Keep talking.
And in the process of losing like 37 pounds.
Woo!
I just, you know, I was just no good. I had to be, you know, I had to be taken care of by my sons and my ex. And I stayed in the hospital the last time, 19 days. And since then, I've been back to the hospital different times, 3, 4, 5 days a time. But I've been back four different times.
Now, I got something to tell you. Sister Karen, y'all. He came in here for the first time. About 3 Sundays ago, he came here for the first time. He told Minister Lauren that since he came in heaven's best, knowing him with all, prayed for him, I gave him an anointing handkerchief. Same thing I'm going to do for you. I'm going to give you a fresh one for you and Quentin. I'm going to give you an anointing handkerchief to take with you.
Yeah.
Give him an anointing handkerchief. He told Mr. Lauren that coming in this place, he said he felt better that week than he's felt in years.
Yeah.
All right? Since June, since June, since it started happening, since they gave it to you in June, you felt better that week than you have felt since it happened.
Yes, this has been approximately 18 days of nothing but better.
18 days of better health. Coming in here, just being in this atmosphere. There's a healer. There's a healer in the house. And his name is Jesus. Stay right there for a minute. Palm of my hand, the holy, healing, glory, fire. When I lay it on you, ooh, it's burning now. Soon as I start talking about it, it begins to burn. Sometimes you feel the burning coming out of my hand, sometimes you don't. It don't matter, you still get healed. But it's burning right now, soon as I bring it up. And when I lay it on you, your healing is healed. But it is sealed by the Star of David. Because I stand with Israel. Y'all hear me? I stand with Jerusalem. Peace in Israel. Whoever blessed Israel, I'll bless them. Whoever cursed Israel, I'll curse them. That's what the Bible said. That's what God said. So I stand with Israel. In the name of Jesus. Totally healed by the power of God in Jesus' name. Amen. Now, right where you are, I'm so glad you're here. Everything has been broken off you today. Not tomorrow, not next week, now. In Jesus' name. Oh, hold on. Look. Oh, no, you good. Sister Michelle, I like what she told me. It's her first time here with her son. She said, Brent, she has been watching us she's been watching us every Sunday on social media for a year and decided to come in here today. Your coming is not in vain. In the name of Jesus. Amen, Lord. I'm going to read it to you, but I'm going to give it to two here, one, two here, and another one here, and Gerald, and Sister Fata, fresh, and Elder Brooks. For those of you who don't remember, honey, if y'all don't remember Elder Brooks, Elder Brooks used to love to hang up in heaven's best back in the day. She would come here and she always brought a grandchild with her.
Yeah, I
remember. We haven't seen it in a while. She called Miss Lawn. She's here today.
Pastor, she has been begging me to get you and I to come over to her house. She said, God been telling me to let Pastor lay hands on me because of this demon that is attacking. She said, the spirit, tell us that Elder Brooks, what happened.
Yeah. What happened?
I was in the prayer line, and we were praying, and this young man, I would have a hands on people, and an unclean spirit jumped on me.
I got you. He can jump off you. Well, then he can ready to jump off you now, permanently. I got you. I got you. Ooh, I feel the glory right now.
I come back this morning.
Uh-huh.
Now, she won't call me that hour. She called me. She called me at what? About 6:30 this morning?
5:30.
Yeah, she was in so much pain.
And I would call him early in the morning like that.
Yeah.
And twice he called me when I was going through.
Amen.
The Lord had him to call me when I was
this going through. This is a woman of God. It's a preacher.
My son is a pastor.
Yeah, her son is a pastor. No, what's going now?
What side of your body is it? Is it your right?
The right. This is the weak side. And what? I had a cardiac arrest.
You did?
Back in 2018.
Okay.
And my head on the side is not even,
no.
It's not acting right.
Oh, no, it's going out right now. Mm-hmm. Is that Jewel? How you doing, Sister Jewel Silver? I know you in here. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Power of God in me. I loose this holy healing glorified to you. Seal with Star David in the name of Jesus. Hold on. Hold on. Oh no, I'm going to pull it out. If you listen to the New Orleans one, the son said that the mama had her eyes closed and I was pulling demons out of her mama with cancer, died of cancer in New Orleans. On the one that's on social media now, already without. And she, after it was over, she told her son, everywhere he pulled, I felt something come out of me. It's real, y'all. Hold on. Huh. Guess what, Elder? God said, you have been a victim of witchcraft, voodoo. Oh, witchcraft and voodoo. Bring me the holy water, Miss Long. I got to get this dirty stuff off of her. The Bible says in Ezekiel 36:25, then will I sprinkle you with clean water, and you shall be cleansed of all your filthiness, and of all your idols will I cleanse you. We ain't Catholic, but I'm going to sling that holy water because the Bible told me. So give me that holy water. I got slinging on this side right now. Let me have it. In the name of Jesus. Ooh, hold on. That thing's strong. That thing's strong. It's coming off you right now. Woo! That thing is real strong. My hand burned like crazy, and I got this. Oh, ready? In the name of Jesus. Cleanse that filthiness off you right now. Aunt Pamela, look at me. Close your eyes. Get this filth off you right now. In the name of Jesus. Close your eyes. Close your eyes. I know. Wait. Wow. We love your aunt. And she love us. Throw this on you, preacher. In the name of Jesus. Throw it on you too. In the name of Jesus. On you too. In the name of Jesus. On you, your head. In the name of Jesus. Just say me. I'm coming to get you. Come on, just say me. Say me. That's all you gotta say to me. Thank you. curse every swelling demon in here right now. All swelling demons die. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, be healed. In the name of Jesus, be healed. Totally healed by the power of God. Totally healed by the power of God. Jesus, healed. Now, hold up a second. Acts the 19th chapter, verse 11 and verse 12. And God wrought special miracles by the hands of Paul, so that from his body, brought him to the sick, handkerchiefs or aprons. The disease departed from them, the evil spirits went out. Don't ever wash it. Don't ever wash it. Don't ever wash this. Keep it until Jesus Christ releases you from it. You can carry it any kind of way you want to. The testimonies from Acts the 19th chapter, verse 11 and 12. And God wrought special miracles by the hands of Paul, so that from his body was brought unto the sick handkerchiefs or aprons, and the diseases departed from them, and the evil spirits went out. This is the point of contact for you from the word of God. It's not the handkerchief, but it's the word that's on it. In the name of Jesus. 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 In the name of Jesus, give me that before I get a different color on. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Acts the 19th chapter, verse 11, 12, all on, okay? Ooh, I feel the glory. In the name of Jesus. You can carry it in your pocketbook. You can carry it in your book bag. Tie it around your door in your house or steering wheel or carry it in your pocket. However you want to do it. It's real. Oh, give me another one. Never wash it. Why? Because God said so in the word. He told Isaiah, don't wash it. Don't ever wash it. Ooh, don't ever wash it. In the name of, give me another one. What's your name? John the Baptist is in the house. Here you go, John. In the name of Jesus, John the Revelator is in the house. Acts the 19th chapter, verse 11 and 12, all on you, will permeate your whole body from head to toe. Let me hear you say supernatural. Huh? In the name of Jesus. Ooh, glory to God. In the name of Jesus. By the power of God, I release healing to your backbone. Into your back. There will be no more pain in your back. In the name of Jesus, I declare your back healed. Restored. In Jesus' name. Amen. Ooh. He goes to the doctor tomorrow. Let me have that water again. You going to the doctor tomorrow, Brother Clarence? Well, let us get you ready for your doctor visit. Doctors do what they do, and we do what we do. In Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I release healing into your heart. Healing to your whole body. By the power of God. That the doctors themselves will see healing for you. And they will see, they say, it's something that I hadn't seen before. Something has happened. And y'all, you gotta say, yeah, I know Jesus did it. In Jesus' name, you're healed. In the name of Jesus. Oh, my hand burning right now. In the name of Jesus. I release this holy healing fire into your head right now. And I can cut loose her head and let her go. The blood of Jesus rebukes thee, Satan. Come out. Come out. Let her go. No more pain in your head in Jesus' name. Amen. Woo! Yeah. Everybody shall have a book of say that. Who? Who? Tonight when you go to bed, put this in the back of your pajamas for a while. Jesus' name, you hear me? Neck, you hear me? I want it closer to your head. Hold on for a minute. Have you got your handkerchief yet? Don't come out you right now. Hold on. Hold on. Sister Charlie, I'll be there in a second. In the name of Jesus, by the power of God. I bind up all the power of the enemy. In the name of Jesus, loose him and let him go. Whatever I loose in the earth is loose in heaven. I bind you to the cross. Bind you to the blood. Bind you to the Holy Ghost. I bind you to the power of God in Jesus' name. And I release this holy healing by seal by the power of God and the Star of David in Jesus' name. Huh? Oh, open your mouth. Drugs and alcohol gotta go. You hear me, ready? Nicotine, cigarette smoke gotta go. Swallow. One for the Father, ready? Ready? One for the Son, and here's one for the Holy Ghost. Gotcha. In the name of Jesus. Okay, I got it. Marlo, right? Deliver Washington, okay? Jesus' name. Acts 19, chapter 11, 12. Now, in the name of Jesus, God wins, therefore we win. Whatever Marlo's doing, Lord, no debt. Lord, I bless Lord. I just got an offering. I already, if you came in late, hold your hand. He gets your offering and you're no debt. No debt, you put it in my hand. In the name of Jesus. I declare Marlo saved, sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost. And that everything that the enemy got him doing stops now in Jesus' name. And return back to the Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Here's his offering, Mrs. Long. Let me have it. We get cigarettes and drugs out of him too. Hold on. I can tell you what kind of cigarettes you smoke. I can tell you. Did you tell me what kind? I can tell you what kind you smoke. Do I know you? No, I don't. I don't know him, but I can tell him what kind of cigarettes he's smoking. I'm telling you what kind you smoke too. Both of y'all smoke Newports. Both of y'all smoke Newports. You smoke Newports, don't you? Huh? Sometimes? Is that the major one you smoke most of the time? It's Newports? No. Newports got a demon in it. It's like say it. In the old days. Yeah. 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 Okay. Yeah. I'm going to have you rededicate. He's working for Mayor Bowser in D.C. Who called me? Yes. Yes, Evangelist. Huh? Oh, hold on. No, I got your spirit right there. I got it. Healed in Jesus' name. Ready? In the name of Jesus, I release the healing power of God into you right now. And I bind up all discomfort and all hurt in your spine, in your tailbone, in your hip bone. And I declare them strengthened now. Like Jesus strengthened the man who couldn't walk. He strengthened his foot bone and his ankle bone. He began to walk, leap, and praise God. Well, the same spirit hitting your backbone now. In Jesus' name, amen. Hey, my bullshit. No debt, see. Yeah. Papers, let me have the papers. Court papers? Oh, you got papers too? No, okay, court papers. Yeah, Vance Rosa. Evangelist Shirley want to bless the church. Isn't that nice of that woman of God? Okay. Evangelist Rosa. Okay, I got you. Hold on. I got your paper and okay, no debt, see? No debt in Jesus' name. And I got your paperwork. Hold on. I'm going to tell y'all what to do. I got your paperwork and I got her paperwork, okay? Okay, put it in there. Okay, I got your paper. Bring your paperwork too. Come on, set the paperwork right here. Okay. And then when I release it, it'll be done. Oh, she writing a check to bless the church. Isn't that beautiful? Because we need, thank God for people who want to write a check and bless this church. So we're going to teach y'all to deal with the supernatural thing to help your life. Power of God. This is deliverance time. Now. I need you totally restored now. I release the healing power of God into your backbone, into all of your body, and your knees too. Holy, you can hardly walk. In the name of Jesus, you shall walk better than you walk. In fact, I declare you're going to walk like a 25-year-old woman. In the name of Jesus, your knees are healed. Your back is healed. And you'll be up here preaching and jumping and leaping. In Jesus' name is done. Amen. Now, a different... Okay. Okay. Ezekiel, what now? 34? Huh? 17. Isaiah? I'm going to sit right there. Okay. Okay, hold on. Okay. Now, I got the no death seeds. As we get ready to leave here, what, there's no death? What? Give her that microphone for me, Miss Long. Give my daughter that microphone. Get Angel Love that microphone. Huh? It's an offer.
Thank you, Brother. Quick announcement.
Thank you.
Sonita, please stand up.
Here.
She's a senior and she has senior dues, so she's doing a fundraiser. If you guys want to buy anything to help her pay for her senior dues, please see her after church.
See who?
Sonita.
Stand up, Sonita.
She's right there. She's standing.
Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you, Angel Love Jones. Hold on. Now. Stand up. Stand up, Sister Jewel. And come up front. Who the other... Come on. Come on. Come on. I'm going to do the Bible on you. I'm going to do the Bible on y'all. Okay, this here. Who's that right there? Oh, that's your two? Okay, well, you stand up here too then. Oh, turn around and face them. Y'all, I love supernatural churches. When people bring papers in here, they win. They get what they want. You understand me? Oh, by the way, Miss Long. Also, on that old Radio Revival one, every Tuesday, Wednesday, 8 o'clock, y'all shouldn't miss not one episode of that. That woman said, that woman came in our church. You know why? She was losing everything. She had to go to court. She was losing everything, her house and everything. She was almost losing her mind because of the pressure. Guess what? She heard us on the radio. So she came up in here and we did with them what we're doing with you. This on there, and she went to the court and guess what? Didn't even have to open her mouth and want everything. Didn't she, Ms. Long? And got all her mind and everything back. Y'all hear me? It's real. So, Ezekiel 34, ain't it? No, Isaiah 37:14. Yeah. Isaiah 37:14. Now here's what I'm ready to do for you. Huh? 14 through 17. Same thing that happened in the Bible. Hezekiah had the paperwork. He received the paperwork. And he didn't like it. He didn't like the paperwork. He needed something different. Go ahead and read it, Ms. Long. He needed something different. We have people coming up in here facing all kinds of stuff, get the paperwork and win. Isaiah 37:14. Read out loud, Miss Long. Isaiah 37:14 for your paperwork. We do everything in here according to the word of God. This is why we got so many victories. That's why we never lose.
Amen. Hallelujah. Isaiah chapter 37, verse 14. And Hezekiah received the letter from the hand of the messengers and read it. And Hezekiah went up unto the house of the Lord.
Are you in the house of the Lord?
That's right.
Are you in the house of the Lord?
Amen.
Are you in the house of the Lord? Are you in the house of the Lord? All right, keep reading.
And spread it before the Lord.
Come on here.
And Hezekiah prayed unto the Lord, saying, O Lord of hosts, God of Israel, thou that dwellest between the cherubims, thou art the God even thou alone,
yes,
of all the kingdom of the earth,
yes,
thou hast made heaven and earth. Incline thine ear and hear, O Lord, and open thine eyes, O Lord, and see. In Jesus' name.
From my hand to yours, when he brought up to the Lord, Lord took care of it. From my hand to yours,
yes,
amen.
Yes. Yes.
From my hand to yours, who's this one? You win, in Jesus' name.
Yes.
From my hand to yours, like Hezekiah, you win in Jesus' name.
Yes.
You win in Jesus' name. From my hand to yours, like Hezekiah, you win in Jesus' name. Give God praise. It's done this. Y'all, before you walk out that door, I know we went overtime. So let me hurry up and dismiss y'all, but here's what I want you to do. I'm going to bless the
sacraments.
Thank you, because you know what I was going to say, don't you?
Condiments.
Condiments.
Oh, we got you covered. Because I sure was thinking condiments again. I shop too much. Anyway, bless the communion, the sacraments. Now, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to bless it with a hand to you. Just go ahead and take it. I'm going to tell you why. Because we're already overtime. And I'm going to stand here. And everyone who just want a quick touch on your way out that door, I'm going to touch you. But before I bless the sacraments, anybody in here who want to give their life to the Lord, you give your life. And anyone who you know that you love the Lord, you may have already been baptized and you with the Lord, but guess what? You need to rededicate because you haven't been going to church like you should, haven't been reading the word like you should, haven't been worshiping like you should, haven't been doing quite like you should. You had little things pulling on you. And you need to get back in the saddle and get the riding. You can rededicate. And for those of you who want to join this Power Pack Church today, believe me, a woman came in here. She said, I didn't come here to join this church. She joined the first Sunday she came here. Why? Because God pulled two tumors out of her body that day. They had already told her she had one tumor count in her body. Pulled three out. Pulled three. I saw them. I told her, you don't have one tumor. You got three tumors in your body. And God used me to pull the tumors out of her body. And guess what? She went back to the doctor. She had no tumor left in her body. And she joined the first time she came. She said, I didn't mean to join. She said, but there's so much power in here, I couldn't resist. And she joined, and she became a preacher in this church. Now, if you want to rededicate, just stand up. If you want to give your life, stand up. If you want to join, stand up right where you are. I like what he just said. Evangelist Fata. Here, Evangelist Fata.
Yes. Amen.
If you want to rededicate your life and start over fresh, just stand up right where you are. You want to give your life to God, or you want to join. Okay, I'm going to bless this. They'll hand them out to you. And they'll come around with a trash can and take it from you. But in the name of Jesus, by his stripes, the stripes that Jesus took on his back, he said, eat my body, and you will be healed. The life is in the blood, the blood, the blood, the blood. There's power in his blood. In the name of Jesus. I love y'all. I'm going to stand right here. I'm going to take my communion right now. And I'll touch you as you walk out that door.
Oh,
yeah, Ms. Lauren.
Evangelist D has the God Win t-shirts at the front door.
At the front door, God wins.
Yeah, so they're $15 a piece. Amen.
Anybody got one on right now? Because I'm going to tell you something. I thought I did too. But they were my, and they got glory t-shirts. My family, my wife, them, they wore those God, they love those God Wins t-shirts. First lady come looking for mine. She up there looking for mine last night. After she done washing and cleaning and everything and ironing whatever. She got mine. That's my God Wins t-shirt, not hers. In the name of Jesus, go ahead and eat the 39 stripes. and then drank that poem. So Ben Shirley has written a love offering for heaven's best. Oh my God. Awesome.
That's my work. And then the other one I had
in mind. Fans of Shirley, yeah, we can't thank you enough. Let me have your hand. 100-fold, I got to thank you. A 100-fold return. A 100-fold return to you. No, 1,000. Into every area of your life and right to your husband. In Jesus' name, for this seed that you sow into heaven's best. Thank you. And your son. Jerry Jr. Now, Jerry Jr. is free now. This seed has set him free. And Jerry Sr. Okay. I love y'all. God bless y'all. And enjoy the rest of the Sabbath day. And as you leave, if you want to touch, I'm going to stand right here. Huh? Yeah, I've already opened doors of the church. I've already done all of that. I'll get a trash can, y'all, so they can throw their stuff away. But I'm going to touch you on your way out the door. And, again, clean your homes this week, spiritually. Oh, I'm going to ahead and cut it off for you. Thank you. In the name of Jesus, heal, now, God.